Wendell Clark played his entire professional hockey career out east. However, he never really left the prairies behind. Clark had a blue-collar work ethic instilled in him while growing up on the family farm near Kelvington. He combined a physical style with a scoring touch, which made him a fan favorite and one of the most exciting players of his generation.
I don't know where the toughness part came out, other than where I grew up and everything, the area I'm from, and my dad, and probably liked doing it. That's why I was doing it. But it really never had a fight or until junior hockey. Played very physical all the way up in minor hockey. There was no rules for fighting pre-junior hockey, so really no reason to fight. And then started in junior, and that was just got to be part of my game. Sometimes too much, but it was probably because I liked doing it.
Clark played minor hockey in the Kelvington area nearby in Yorkton before moving to Notre Dame in 1981. The following season, he took his talents to the Western Hockey League, where he starred on defense for the Saskatoon Blades. His successful junior career attracted the attention of Canada's World Junior Hockey Team. It also caught the eye of the National Hockey League, particularly the Toronto Maple Leafs, who selected Clark first overall in the 1985 NHL Draft.
A huge honor, very fortunate to get to go first overall, and the draft was in Toronto for the first time, not in Montreal, so it made for a big fanfare, hometown team drafting first. Probably less nerve-wracking for me than a lot of guys. I never had to wait that long. But really kind of knew I was going to go in the top three, but wasn't 100% sure I was going to go one until it happened.
Being selected first overall may not have been much of a surprise for Clark. However, there was a surprise waiting for him at his first training camp with the Leafs.
I never started as a forward until I got to the NHL, so I was a defenseman my whole life. Really, World Junior Tournament, I played half the games defense and half the games forward. And first day of training camp at 18 in Toronto is when they said, you're forward.
With his crushing body checks, deadly wrist shot, the Toronto fans loved Clark. He was named captain in 1991 and held that honor until 1994. In his second season as captain, Clark and the Leafs battled through the playoffs and got within one win of the Stanley Cup final before losing to the LA Kings. Despite the loss, it was a series he remembers fondly.
It's probably reeled back to further when we started against Detroit. They had a fella, Bob Probert, was on the team, and I had their strict rules by Pat Burns, you will not be fighting Probert at all in the series. No off limits. So then when Marty, we were winning the game one, and we were going to win, and Marty was setting the tone for his team, saying we're not done, this is going to be a long series. So he hits our best player, and as I said to myself, Burnsy didn't say I couldn't go after him. So that's kind of how that one happened. And it really, that whole series had a lot of, it looks chippy, but a lot of fun stuff. There's a lot of great goal scoring when you see the Doug Gilmores and Wayne Gretzky's, a lot of toughness going on. The games all had, 5-4 scores. So it was, for a fan, I think it was very exciting. And so that was a lot of fun, that series.
In 1994, Clark was traded to the Quebec Nordiques. After a career spent in Toronto, he didn't hear about the move firsthand.
It happened. Didn't know it happened. It happened on the day of the draft. I was actually filling up with gas at the gas station to turn the radio on to see who we drafted in first pick, and that's when I heard I got traded.
Clark then moved on to the New York Islanders, but was soon back in Toronto again. He rounded out his career with the Tampa Bay Lightning, Detroit Red Wings, Chicago Blackhawks, and a third and final stint with the Maple Leafs. Clark's numbers have been retired by the Saskatoon Blades and Toronto Maple Leafs. In 2017, his statue was also added to Legends Row outside the Toronto Maple Leafs arena.
It's great. I got to go out and polish it every day because the birds are crapping on me all the time. But it's another big one. You're standing in that bronze lineup of the lineup there, and I go, I think I'd have a hard time making that team. That's a pretty good hockey team to be on. Those guys standing there, and I think I'm in the pose. I'm jumping over the boards, and Daryl Sittler's jumping over the pose in the boards in the pose. And I said, Daryl's the one that's going on the ice. I'm going over to serve a penalty. I wouldn't be going on the ice. But that's another great part to be a part of the organization and be, like I say, mentioned with those guys on that bench. That'd be a fun team to play on.
Installed in the Saskatchewan Sports Hall of Fame on September 28th, 2019, Wendell Clark.